Hey guys, what is up? It's Dusty here, and welcome back to another crypto video. And my question of today is, are you still bullish on crypto? Yes or no? Put it down in the comment section below. And all the goofy, funny stuff aside, I definitely think you guys should sit down for this video to really let it sink in, all right? Just maybe stop whatever you're doing and think about what we're going to be talking about here today. Because this is pretty detrimental for the whole lawsuit and for everything in the future regarding crypto and the law, all right? It basically comes down to something which John Deaton has said over on Twitter, but a lot of this also has to do with the recent risk alert that came out and everything surrounding that. It's really interesting in my opinion. So to start off, I know it's pretty long, but you can see from the amount of likes that this is definitely something important, all right? So John Deaton, he said, XRP holders versus US SEC, notice of pending legal action. What that basically refers to is a little while before actually going in for legal action, you have to let others know. Now, I'm not exactly sure if you have to do this via Twitter or just, you know, kind of post it somewhere, like send a letter to your friends. I'm not sure how. Maybe you have to make it public at least. But this is something that they do all the time. Maybe it's also to grab attention, which we'll see in just a second. XRP community, please forward to any XRP holder who owns XRP and wishes to join in the class action lawsuit to be filed against the SEC. Please be advised that after I file the lawsuit, I must demonstrate to the court that I am able to notify the potential members of the class in order to have the case be certified as a class action lawsuit pursuant to the federal rules. Quote, the notice may be one or more of the following: United States mail, electronic means, or other appropriate means. One viable means today is the use of social media. Obviously, Twitter is not going to serve as the only means of communicating to potential members of the class action, but it definitely serves as a good starting point. There are other means available as well that I intend to use to notify all persons who qualify and want to be included in the lawsuit. Most of the time, a lawyer will file a class action lawsuit and then attempt to identify the members of the class afterwards. I want to have as many of the members identified as early as possible. Plus, there is strength in numbers, and I want to demonstrate a strong united class of XRP holders at the very outset of the case. The XRP holders that owned XRP on December 22nd, 2020 are likely to be considered the most relevant claimants in the lawsuit against the SEC. That part basically refers to the fact that if you started to hold XRP afterwards, you're purchasing it basically after the SEC has already put up some judgment, so you're not really a valid, at least not as valid as the other ones. Let's move on though. At this point of the process, we simply want to be able to demonstrate the ability to ascertain the potential members of the class. We are not at the point of determining with certainty who qualifies as an actual member of the class. Therefore, I'm looking for all persons who previously owned XRP on December 22nd, 2020, and who own it currently. This includes all potential members, whether they reside in the US or outside the US. Please understand that this notice does not constitute any promises or assurances that any particular person will be included, nor is it a promise or assurance that anyone will receive any form of compensation whatsoever. It should also be noted that there is no promise, guarantee, or assurance that I will be certified as the lead trial lawyer that will represent the class. This tweet and notification is for information gathering purposes only. If a class action is in fact certified and I'm not appointed as the lead attorney, I'll provide any information I obtain to the court and or to any other counsel appointed by the court. The only assurances and guarantee that I do make is that your name will only be shared for the purposes of the lawsuit and not released to any third parties. And finally, there will be no request made by me or anyone associated with me for anything from you other than your name, email address, or other contact information. I have noticed on Twitter that sometimes scam artists, criminals, create fake accounts pretending to be someone and ask for money or crypto, etc. If you receive such requests from any account claiming to be me or associated with me, it is a fake and a scam. If you ever have any concerns or questions, you can contact me at the Deaton Law Firm at these numbers or via email. There will be other means used to notify potential members of the class action down the road. For example, the Flare Spark Token airdrop took a snapshot of all XRP accounts less than 2 weeks before the SEC filed the case against Ripple. After the case is filed, we can seek out that information. I'm sharing this with you because I don't want to give an impression that you must contact me or my office immediately in order to be included. Like I said, I'm just recording the names of those that already definitely know that they want to join in on the fight against the SEC. If you want to be included in the lawsuit, including your name, potentially listed on the complaint or pleadings, please DM me on Twitter and email me at that thing. If you do, both the DM and the email, it'll make sure that your name is included, and I am aware that many of you have already contacted the law firm and my intentions to be included known to me, or made your intentions to be included known. I've maintained those emails, thank you. We are all witnessing the SEC make a huge power grab in the case against Ripple and XRP. The latest risk alert published by the SEC regarding digital assets makes it clear that the SEC is successful against Ripple. Will not stop with only XRP. So if they are successful against Ripple, they will not stop. All digital assets are at stake. We either sit around and bitch and moan, or we take the fight to them, which is basically a reply to his previous little tweet, which says here, why the SEC v. Ripple case is the most significant SEC enforcement case in modern history, part four. And yeah, I've said it before, it most likely is the most important case. But this whole thread here, I don't think we're going to read all the way through. You can do it for yourself, though, if you are, you know, feeling nice about it. The point, however, is quite clear that right now is going to be a lawsuit against the SEC, a class action lawsuit from XRP holders. We saw a part of this already with the basic complaint. We saw it before. But right now he's taking it a little step further, a little bit more official. And you can see the amount of attention. And if you check through the comments, you notice that there's a lot of people who want to be in. All right. And you should also not underestimate the XP community. First of all, how many people are in there? And second of all, how many just different sides of people there are. Right. I would actually like to have legal briefs, right? The XP attorney, or at least the attorney who also covers XRP sometimes, to also, you know, comment on this to see exactly what his view is, if it makes any sense, if it would ever work. But to me, an initiative like this is very good. Even though, if you really start to look at it from the perspective of how much can it do, you know, you start to debate about things a little bit, because, well, even if you go for a class action lawsuit, the only thing you can really do is sue them, right, for the damages they've done to us. Or sue them because they're doing something which is immoral or not right. But that would also figure itself out in the Ripple v. SEC case, right? So I'm not exactly sure what the point is going to be that won't be figured out in the Ripple case. Maybe it's just kind of a second option if the Ripple case fails, or maybe it's something along those lines that they should make a new test for crypto because it's been done unfair. That I'm not yet sure. He hasn't made that very clear as of yet. But, you know, the point, in my opinion, is pretty clear. The SEC right now has, from a certain perspective, too much power, but mostly they have a very negative mission towards crypto. I don't know who the boss is in that sense, who decided that this should be the case. But what we do know, though, is that they're not doing this out of the best interest of the investor or of us, basically. So here on investing.com, there's just a small little part. I guess it's from CoinQuora, but it's about the SEC giving a risk alert. But let's quickly read through it, right? The US SEC has discussed risk alert on digital asset securities. According to the SEC, they examine a lot more issues before they permit any crypto company to operate. The US SEC has addressed risk alerts in reference to digital asset securities. The SEC gave the alert based on how crypto companies offer, issue, and trade crypto. However, the SEC underscores that there are a lot more issues that need to be addressed on a crypto's company applications before they become broker-dealers. Wait, was I there? Yes, need to be addressed. Yeah. According to the SEC, cautions and risk assessment on digital asset securities are not subject to warnings. Instead, it is based on the authority's point of view. Concerning the SEC's division of examinations, they do more reviews on crypto investment companies. As per the SEC, crypto exchanges really attract much more issues in terms of registrations. The SEC Commissioner Hester Pierce, also known as Crypto Mom, took the SEC's risk alert to Twitter and asked people to share their ideas. SEC's exam division released a risk alert on digital assets. I welcome your feedback. Put it down there. Recently, the SEC also sued Ripple. Point being, in my opinion, it is really strange how this went through. That's kind of the basis of things. I don't fully understand what the SEC is planning, why they're doing this, and what their goal is going to be ultimately. Like, Do they really just want to get rid of everything that these guys are doing in the crypto space or what? Because the way I'm seeing it right now is they are classifying everything as kind of an open case. And hear me out, right? I checked out here, US SEC. And you know what I've noticed? That there's actually quite a lot of debatable points throughout this list. And if you look up a couple of names regarding US SEC crypto, something like that, you'll notice there's quite a lot of articles about revokes or revoking things. I'm sometimes thinking, what if they ever revoke the Bitcoin and Ethereum verdict or try to by suing? And that that's actually going to be another point of interest, right? Because they've also given already this risk alert, which might have been because some people have, for example, said that the SEC should have given people notice that XP was a security already, which they didn't do. Right now, they gave a sort of a risk warning for things in the baseline. I'm really wondering here, will they actually stay true to their verdict on Bitcoin and Ethereum, or will they come after XRP and see it went really easily, potentially, then go after the next one, then go after the next one, and really put crypto into the ground as a whole? Because really looking at it from this perspective, there's not really too much room for growth or too much room for negotiating, because they'll just really see almost everything as a crypto security or a digital asset security, I should say. Where is the line drawn? They see a lot of these things as them, and which ones do they truly see as decentralized? Which ones do they? Is Cardano truly decentralized? Is Ethereum truly decentralized? Well, the real factors behind those decisions are unclear to us, which is why we want, of course, the documents explaining why Ethereum wasn't a security. But for right now, I really don't understand what they're doing, what their plan is. And mostly, I think this lawsuit could really change things, even though I don't necessarily know what they'll be suing for. I just think the SEC at this point is not acting out of their best interest for the people that they claim to defend. It's not acting in our best interest, which are, again, the people. And they're basically just hurting innovation without real backing to it. I'm saying fines are all good. Even restrictions are all good. But really calling the crypto a security is a very, very difficult choice and something which is not applicable. I just personally don't think it is. I think a new test needs to be made for a newer day cryptocurrency or slash digital asset because the Howey test for real world assets, it just doesn't work anymore. But then comes the question, what party in the US, for example, will have the authority to make a rule like that? Because it's basically encompassing quite a lot of different bodies of the US. If we're talking about digital assets, we're talking about everything digital, right? We're not talking about cryptocurrency specifically, because those two things are a very big difference, right? I've explained it before. Digital assets, I said in the live stream, is basically, you should see it in simple terms as everything online. You know, things that are online in bits, basically. Digital currencies are that specific thing, which can be everything, but then currencies to the dot. And then cryptocurrencies are then a little bit more of a specific digital currency or a digital asset, really, which rely on some sort of cryptography or at least encryption. I think you guys get the picture. They're different things, though, which is also another very important part of the lawsuit between Ripple and the SEC because they use different terms for them. One uses digital something, the other uses cryptocurrency. Point being, right, that valuation, how you see things, if they really have a good test for digital assets, I don't think XRP would come out of the whole thing negatively. I think things would be fixed pretty simply. But as at this point, man, I think the complaint box must be full, but they really just don't care. Or at least they're not listening to the people too well. But I'm wondering what's going to happen with the lawsuit. I thought you really guys should know that this is going through and that they're planning it. Ton of likes, ton of people engaging with this. So it will definitely pull through to some extent. What type of influence it will have, not sure about that, but it is there, all right? So now you know about it, if you didn't before. Maybe some other guys have commented on this or gotten it out before. I don't know, but at least I did my job. Tether hit with a 500 Bitcoin ransom demand, but it says it won't pay. I just saw that. I thought I should also quickly notify you guys. And what is this? It's a contest, huh? Tether hit with a 500 Bitcoin ransom demand, but it says it won't pay. The USDT stablecoin issuer says it received a $23 million ransom demand payable by Monday. The deadline has since passed and Tether isn't paying. Somebody, hackers purportedly threatened to leak documents that would harm the Bitcoin ecosystem if the ransom demands weren't met. It's interesting, huh? I don't want to get too deep into this because, well, you can most likely talk about these stories every single day. I'm not sure how sophisticated this is because I don't trust either of these parties. So who cares, right? It's just interesting that this pulled through. Today, we also received a ransom demand for 500 Bitcoin to be sent to this address. I'm wondering if somebody sent something there. We can actually look it up, by the way. If you ever were wondering if somebody has sent money to a certain address, what you can do is just type in to whatever browser you're using. For example, Bitcoin or BTC scanner, or you can type in Bitcoin Block Explorer. Let's go for Explorer. Bitcoin Explorer. The first one is blockchain.com. I'm typing in the address right now. Enter. Let's quickly see. So yeah, it has received one transaction of 0.0000014 Bitcoin. And that is basically that. It's basically 72 cents. It received that today at about 2 p.m. if you were wondering. So that is that. Twitter pulls a MicroStrategy. Oh, sorry, guys. Twitter pulls a MicroStrategy, announces 1.4 billion convertible notes offering. So Jack Dorsey is now also going for the MicroStrategy, deal, where they are right now putting up notes due 2026, with initial purchase having a 13-day option to buy up an additional $187.5 million to cover any of the allotments, if any. They'll be convertible into cash, Twitter common stock, or a combination at Twitter's election. And it's basically to buy crypto, right? I think so. I'm not sure if it actually is, but it kind of would look like that. While MicroStrategy's Saylor used the proceeds from the two rounds of debt issuance to buy Bitcoin, it hasn't revealed what Dorsey will be doing with the total of approximately $1.4 billion raising funds. I'm thinking he's going to buy Bitcoin, though. I'm thinking, but we don't really know. We don't really know, right? Maybe Twitter is going to buy Bitcoin, too. It'd be interesting. And then Paul Singer warned of head-smacking craziness in markets and said there could be trouble ahead. But again, that's every single guy. They, at least at one point, have said, oh, there's going to be some trouble along the road, so be careful. Who cares about guys like this? I personally don't. But yeah, that was it for today's video. Hopefully you all enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you press the like button and subscribe. And I'll definitely see you guys again in another crypto video. Adios, amigos.